Hey, I'm Rana. I'm one of the educators at the North Carolina Aquarium on Roanoke Island. But I'm not at the aquarium today. I, like many of you, are in my own house. And I am doing a series on what we call backyard biology. I'm challenging you to learn something from your own backyard. And today I'm standing right in front of a stick pile. Why would I have a stick pile in my yard? Well, you know, when we are trying to encourage folks to think about habitat in their own yards, this is an example of a great way to create some lovely habitat. Whenever you're considering creating habitat in your backyard for the critters who live near you, there's four things you want to provide. One is food, whether it's in the way of bird feeders or in plants. Water, like water dishes, water features. Third is space, which is your yard. And fourth is shelter. And so when you're thinking about shelter, you might consider bird boxes or bird houses. Or you might consider a stick pile like this. The stick pile provides shelter for many different kinds of animals. As you're cleaning up your yard this spring, as you're grabbing branches and stuff like that, just if you can find a place in your yard to put a pile, that is a wonderful place for overwintering insects like butterflies. The mourning cloak is a good example. Red admiral is another one that loves to hang out in something like this over the winter. It's also a neat place for little birds. Things like wrens and little birds like that can use this bush pile, this stick pile, to have a nice place to hang out in. And yes, our friend Mr. No Shoulders, snakes will also use this, as well as turtles. Box turtles can find themselves a little place to hide out in a stick pile like this. So next time you're cleaning up your yard, consider building a stick pile for the critters that call your place home. Well, that's it for today's episode. I'm challenging you to get in your own backyard, see what you can learn as we're going through the springtime. See you later.